Hello, my dear friends. My name is Alberto. Welcome to this episode of AMP for WordPress. In the last episode, we started our deep dive into all the features and capabilities the official AMP plugin for WordPress puts at your fingertips to make it easy to take advantage of AMP in your content strategy. In this episode, we are going to see how to get started with AMP using the Reader Template mode. Let's consider the following scenario. You have already a complex website. You are using a theme and a set of plugins that are not incompatible. You are not a developer, or you may be a developer, but you don't have time or resources at this moment to tackle development tasks, and you want to bring AMP user experiences to your users right away. In this scenario, you can take advantage of the official AMP plugin Reader Template mode, which we introduced in the last episode. Let's get on the computer and configure the AMP plugin in Reader mode right away. So the first thing that we're going to do is to get a full WordPress site running locally on my machine. If you want to follow along, or if you want to do this later on your own, you can get also a full WordPress site running on your machine using any of the options that are available out there. For this demonstration, I'm using local by Flywheel because it's a very simple and effective option. I use it all the time. Here we have my WordPress site. It's a very simple new site. I'm using a theme that is called Color Mac that you can find in the WordPress.org repository. It is a nice theme indeed, but it's not incompatible at all. You can see that we have like a navigation menu here. We have some features here that show you the latest news, social sharing, a search button, a sidebar, a footer, and so on. And if we go to the dashboard, we can go to the theme section and we see that we have indeed Color Mac is the active theme, and we also have some core themes installed, specifically 2019, 2020, 21. And if we go to the plugin section, we can see that we have no plugins installed at all. So it's a brand new site, empty, ready for us to test our AMP install. Let's install the official AMP plugin for WordPress. Here in the plugin dashboard of your local WordPress site, let's click Add New. And then in the search box here, we're gonna type AMP. And then the first result that comes up, it says AMP, the official AMP plugin supported by the AMP team. This is the one that we want. Okay, so let's click here on Install Now. And once the installation is complete, click on the Activate button, and that's it. Voila, we have the AMP plugin installed on our site. We can see a few things here. We see that there is a welcome banner. The plugin is, you know, telling us that he's up and running. We have an entry point to the onboarding wizard. And here in the plugin section, the plugin list, we have the only plugin that we have installed, that is the AMP plugin. And here it tells you the purpose, the version, and so on. And here we have an entry point to the settings screen. We can deactivate the plugin if needed. And then here on the left-hand side, we have a new menu that contains AMP options. And in this case, we have only settings and analytics, and we will see in future episodes how this menu can actually be populated with more options depending on the configuration that we choose. Now, in order to configure the AMP plugin, we have several options. We can, as I said, go into the onboarding wizard, or we can go to the settings screen that we can access here or in the menu in the left-hand sidebar. But because this is the first time that we install the plugin, let's follow with the onboarding wizard. Clicking on the onboarding wizard link in the plugin dashboard takes us to the welcome screen that the official plugin gives us, you know, and here it tells us a bit about what the plugin does, what is the value proposition that it brings to you and to your site, and what to expect from following this onboarding flow. So if we click next, the first thing that the plugin asks us is we are technical. And basically the plugin is trying to determine if we are developers or technically savvy, so that we can deal with more technical complexity. And if not, then the plugin is going to provide us a simpler setup. Given the scenario that we are addressing in this episode, I want to select that I am not technically savvy, or maybe I am, but I want a simpler setup in this scenario. When we click next, the next phase is associated with the template mode. If you are not familiar with the amp plugin template mode, please check the previous episode in which we go in detail about each one. And here we have the three options that the plugin offers: standard, transitional, and reader. Notice that the reader template mode is highlighted in green as the best option, given that we answered that we are not technical in the previous question. Each section here tells you what the mode is and when it would be a good choice for you. So let's select that we want to use reader mode and then click next. And the next part of the onboarding flow is theme selection. Here we are going to select the theme template that will be used for reader mode. And here the plugin says the template for mobile visitors, and we will see more about this in a second. So there are many options that we have. Specifically, we can select any of the core theme except 2010. I think that is non-responsive, but other than that, we have all the core themes available that we can use as our reader theme. And we also have something that is called the AMP legacy theme. That is a very simple set of templates that have been available with the plugin from the beginning. But we want to use a full theme, a full core theme. Specifically, I want to give it a try to the new 2021 core theme. So I'm going to select it here. We click next, and that's it. In the next step, the plugin offers a review of what we have done so far. It tells us that we are using reader mode and why it is good. Here, there is an option to automatically redirect visitors to our site that are coming from mobile devices to the AMP version of our site. And I want to re-emphasize that, because that is the case where good performance and good user experience is going to be of paramount importance, given the conditions that usually mobile devices experience. Here, the plugin tells us that we are using Color Mac for the desktop visitors, and we are using 21 for the reader mode or the mobile visitor. So we click next, and the plugin saves the settings. It congratulates the configuration that we did. We are ready to go, and it provides an embedded view of our site that we can browse in place if we want. We also can see that we have a browse AMP button that if we click, it's going to take us to another tab, and then we go directly to the AMP version of our site. And we also have an entry point to the customizer for the reader theme. You know, in reader mode, our site has two themes, one for the non-AMP and one for the AMP version. And consequently, we also have two versions of the customizer. We can use the customizer for the non-AMP version or the customizer for the AMP version. Here, the plugin and the onboarding flow provides us an entry point to the customizer for the AMP version. But before, we want to see the customizer in a little bit. But before that, let's do a review of how our configuration looks like. So we want to click on the close button and go to see our site. So let's click on the top left menu that has a visit site link. So we go there. Now, we know this configuration already, and because we are using 2021 theme and 2021 is a fully incompatible theme, then the whole site has an equivalent AMP version. And we can see here that for the top page, for the main homepage, we have also an entry point for the AMP version. But let's look a specific post to see how the post look. So again, this is the non-AMP version, and we see in the admin bar that there is an entry point for the viewing the AMP version. So we click there, and here we have, you know, a very neat AMP version of our site according to the baseline setup of the 2021 theme. So it's very clean, and, you know, very beautiful. But there are certain things that I don't like. For example, here we don't have a navigation menu, so we don't have a way for our users to navigate through our site once they are in an AMP post. Also, I would like to change the color, the background color of the post, so that they are more in sync with the non-AMP version of the site, so we have more harmony between the two. And also, I would like to have some social sharing buttons here, so it's important for me that my users have the opportunity to share the content that they visit in our site. So when reader mode is selected, there are two themes that are acting on our site, one for the AMP version and one for the non-AMP version. And therefore, there are also two versions of the customizer, one for each version of our site. For example, here, if we are in the non-AMP version and we click on the customize link on the admin bar, this is going to take us to the non-AMP version of the customizer. Likewise, if we are browsing a post and we go to the to see the AMP version by clicking on the AMP link on the admin bar, and then we go to the customize link on the admin bar, this is going to take us to the AMP version of the customizer. And here we can configure many aspects of the site. Site identity, colors, background image, menus, and so on. So we said that we wanted to select a background color that is more in harmony with the color selection or the color palette of the non-AMP version. So we're gonna go to the color section. We're gonna select the background color, and we are gonna select something that is more whitish to be more similar to the non-AMP version. Then we are gonna go to the menus, and we're going to make sure that, you know, there are three menus defined in the 2021 theme. We're gonna go to view all locations, and we're gonna here select the primary menu for the primary location, and also the primary menu for the secondary location. With this, we're gonna publish our site, and we're gonna go back, and voila! Now we have a better color that matching our non-AMP version. We have a navigation menu here, and we still have the rest of the post, leaving comments, navigation, and so on. The other aspect that we wanted to change in our site was to make sure that we have social sharing buttons for both our pages. And it's very important to do that, so we allowed our visitors to our site to share the content that they encountered with their social network. And we can do that very easily by installing a very popular plugin that is called Jetpack, which is developed by Automattic. So let's do that. Let's go to the dashboard again, to the plugin section specifically, and we are going to select add new. And here we have it, because it's one of the most popular plugins, we have it already, but if you don't have it in the first search result, you can look for it here in the search box. But now when we add here, we're gonna click install. When the installation is complete, then we can go ahead and activate it. So the next step is going to be configuring the sharing module of the Jetpack plugin. So we will do this by going to the settings. There is a message here that has to do with the fact that we are running Jetpack locally. You can disregard that. And then here we have several sections, and one of them is sharing. That is the one that we are interested in right now. So here we have a section on sharing buttons, and we toggle this button that says add sharing button to your post and pages. And now we can configure them to make sure that we have the ones that we want. I want to use the standard ones that are the most important for me: Twitter, Facebook, and LinkedIn. And I want to use only the icon version of it. I don't want to use the icon and text. And here it says show buttons on posts and pages, and that's it. So I save changes, and now let's make sure that they appear consistently. So I want to go to first to the non-AMP version of my site. Let's pick up a post, and then here we see the social sharing buttons added by Jetpack. If I go to the AMP version of my post and browse down, I see that I have the same social sharing buttons that look identical to the non-AMP version. So with this, I have an AMP version of my post that I really like. It's kind of sleek, you know, with a baseline setup of 2020. One, the core theme with a better color scheme for my site. I have a navigation menu that if I go here, I can see that it's fully responsive. And I have my shiny social sharing buttons in place. During the configuration of our site that we did following the onboarding flow wizard, remember that we toggled the button that enables automatic redirection for our mobile users to go directly to the AMP version of our site. So let's see that in action. Here we have our site as it serves to the desktop visitors. And if I go to any of the posts, I will land in the non-AMP version of the post, right? But now imagine again that we are in the homepage. I'm going to switch to a mobile viewport. So here is for like an iPhone 10. And now here I'm still looking at the desktop version of my site because I just switched in developer tools. So I'm going to select to a post. Destruction in Montana, here, whatever that is. I'm sorry to hear that. New. Now we are gonna land in the AMP version automatically. So the AMP plugin detected that this URL was being requested from a mobile agent and it served directly the AMP version of it. And the most important thing is that once we are in an AMP version of our site, on a post or a page, then the plugin automatically enables what is called AMP-to-AMP linking. So if I go to any other section of my site, then I'm going to land on the AMP version of my site. So the users that arrive via mobile devices stay on an AMP experience as they navigate our site. So automatic mobile redirection is very important because then we allow our users to remain experiencing AMP as they navigate our site from mobile device. However, there may be scenarios in which a user wants to go to the non-mobile or the non-AMP version of our site, even if they are visiting from a mobile device. So to allow for that, the plugin adds little functionality that we can take advantage of. Let's take a look. So here we have the non-AMP version of our site. So let's suppose that we go, we are browsing on a mobile device and we go to a post, right? So here we go to a post because we have automatic mobile redirection. We then land in the AMP version of our site. So the user is, you know, looking at our site, we have the share buttons, the responsive menu, but then they say, well, I want to see how the non-AMP version looks in my mobile device. So I can go to the bottom of the post and I have a link that is called XE mobile version here. And that takes me to the non-AMP version of our post, regardless of the fact that we are on a mobile agent. And if I browse all the way to the bottom of the post, then I have a corresponding go to mobile version link. So I can go back to the mobile version. And once I am in the mobile version, then AMP-to-AMP linking remains, and then I can continue navigating my site on the AMP version and go back and forth between both as I wish. We saw how to configure the plugin using the onboarding wizard. It was a simple flow, a few steps, and we were ready to go. Now, we can always go back and change any of those parameters at any given time using the AMP plugin settings screen. Let's see how to do that. If we go to the dashboard by hovering here to the site menu and then clicking on the dashboard menu link, we are taken to the dashboard. And remember, when we installed and activated the AMP plugin, there was an AMP menu that was added to the left-hand side bar. If we hover over it, there is a settings menu link. If you click on it, we are taken to the AMP settings screen. Here at the top, we see that we have an entry point to reopen the onboarding wizard if we decide to go back and rerun it again. And we have also an entry point to go to the Reader Theme Customizer to change the aspect of our theme, as we saw from the onboarding flow. The second section had to do with the template mode that was also part of the onboarding flow. Here we see that this corresponds to the choices that we made there. We have Reader Mode as our template mode, and we are using 2021 as our Reader Theme. If we wanted to change that theme, then we can go here and we will have the same options that we saw during the onboarding flow. Here you can see also that you have the toggle button to turn on and off automatic mobile redirection so that visitors to our site from mobile devices are taken automatically to the AMP version. If you want to change that, you can do it here. And there are a few other sections that we will study in detail in upcoming episodes of this series. Today, we learned quite a bit. We focus on the scenario where we are not developers, or maybe we are, but we want a simple setup. We are using an active theme, which is not AMP compatible. And we installed the plugin, activated it, and configured it to take advantage of the Reader template mode. You can review the details of the Reader mode and also details on how to incorporate more Reader theme options in the documentation section of the AMP plugin site. And remember, if you're having any difficulty setting up AMP on your site, or if you have specific questions about any of the aspects of the official AMP plugin, please do not hesitate to engage with us and our friendly and very AMP savvy support team in the WordPress support forums. In the next episode, we will continue our deep dive of the official LAMP plugin for WordPress, and we will learn how to use it in its ideal template mode configuration, the standard mode. If you are not familiar with the standard mode, make sure that you review the documentation in the plugin site and also watch the previous episode in this series. So stay tuned, don't forget to click on the subscribe button and enable notifications, and let's make it happen.